Hello everybody, my name is Ben and this is Daisy May, and today's cooking video is going to be what? How to make
roast chicken.
And what is the bit of roast chicken that is your favourite?
The chicken.
And those things we're about to make?
Roast chicken.
Yorkshire puddings.
Oh, Yorkshire puddings.
So Daisy's favourite thing is Yorkshire puddings, and we're going to show you how to make them. So we will gather our ingredients and we'll be right back.
We're back. We've got all of our ingredients and Daisy is just going to tell you what we've got. What have we got, Daisy?
A cup of flour, a cup of eggs. No!
Right, we're back. We've got all of our ingredients out and Daisy's now going to tell you what we got. What have we got, Daisy?
A cup of flour, a cup of milk, 3 eggs and a bit of salt.
Perfect. And what are we going to do with them all?
We're going to throw them in the jug and whisk them all up.
Okay, so do you want to put the flour in? Do we need to sieve the flour or not? Can you just chuck it in like that?
Yes.
We can just chuck it in, it's fine. Okay, cool. And then we're going to do a cup of milk. What is that milk you're using?
Lactose free.
Do you have to use lactose free or can it be any milk?
You can use normal milk or lactose free.
Okay, and we use lactose free because your brother is lactose intolerant, right?
Yep.
Okay, but it does seem to work really well, this milk. We use whole fat milk and it seems to make really good Yorkshires. Oh, you have to be careful. Okay, awesome. Right, now.
3 eggs.
Some eggs.
That you're
gonna crack. Well, I'm gonna crack them. I tell you what, you do one, I'll do one.
No, you do
I need
two.
To switch hands. Right, 1, 2, 3.
Oh. I'm gonna
and
no, you're doing that.
I'll do this one. Always important to wash your hands, hey guys.
Before you start though.
Okay, right. Awesome. Now what do we do, Daisy?
And we whisk it all up.
Okay. We'll be back once we put the whisk together because we forgot. Just added a little bit of salt and we put our whisk together. Oh, it's a crazy whisk. Right, put it all the way to the bottom and then turn it on. Put it all the way in. No, stick it all the way to the bottom and then, yeah, there we go. Wow. Make sure you get it all whisked up. Got some stuff down there. Know what I do, how I take the whisk out.
How?
Leave it, put it all the way to the bottom, make it go running, make it turn it on, and then really slowly lift it up. Really slowly. Okay, now turn it off. See, now that you've got no dribbles on there.
Can I
put it in? Good trick. Yep. Right, we'll be back for the next phase, which is going to be the beginning of our roast potatoes.
Yeah.
Right, so we now are going to leave our Yorkshire batter to one side and we're going to peel the potatoes for our roast potatoes. And then there's a couple of tricks to making the perfect roast potatoes, isn't there, Daisy? And we are going to show you our perfect roast potato recipe. Fast forward for potato peeling. Right, so we've got our potatoes peeled and now it's time to chop them. I like to chop them at sort of angles like that because you get a bigger surface area and when they boil, you can get more little furry bits on them. So we're gonna chop all these bugs up. Some of the bigger ones you might wanna chop in half. Get them some little ones, some bigger ones, but all.
Get that one.
You don't want them that say they're massively different sizes, because some of them won't cook as evenly. But you think I'm chatting too much about the size of the potatoes, don't you? So we'll keep chopping them all up. Get some nice big ones. I'm gonna do this one all little ones because Dee likes little ones.
There we go. I like big ones.
Daisy likes big ones. How's that camera work, Daisy? Is it a bit jiggly there? A bit wobbly? You want to try and hold it still, man?
I am.
You make our viewers seasick. Right, we've got all those chopped up, and then we're going to chuck a bit more boiling water into this here pot.
Dad, you didn't mention you take a pot and...
Huh?
You didn't mention take a pot and boil it.
Well, you're going to need a big pan of boiling water.
Yeah.
Chuck some salt in there as well.
Salt?
There
that
we go.
Is not grated.
Yeah, it will dissolve though, won't it? Right, we're going to get all those in there. We're going to boil these for about 10 minutes.
Make sure it doesn't splash you.
The amount of time you boil your potatoes for depends on how old the potato is. Newer potatoes, fresher
like
potatoes.
Ours are very
these
nice.
Came from the shop today, so these will take a bit longer because they're a bit harder. But if you, the best potato to use for a roast potato is a really old one. These are Maris Pipers. My favourite potato to use is a Maris Piper that's just started to go a bit soft. So when you get it out, it's a bit squishy. When you peel it, a big bit of peel comes off. Those ones will probably only take about 6 or 7 minutes to boil. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to boil those for about 10 minutes until they just get a little bit soft on the outsides. And then we're going to drain the water off of them into this jug. And add a couple of stock cubes to that, and that's going to help make our base for our gravy later on. So now, whilst the potatoes are boiling, we are going to start preparing the vegetables for our gravy. Vegetables and gravy, I hear you say? What on earth? Well, this is how we make gravy in our house. Be careful, Daisy.
I am.
Use this hand on there. Push.
This?
Yep. Be careful.
Yeah.
Drop your knife down, there you go. Don't want to go to A&E today, do we?
Definitely.
Alright, rock the knife. Push that end. There you go. Good girl. So that's how you want your onion chopped. We'll come back when that's all chopped. Right, now we're going to chop our celery up into little chunks. They don't have to be that small, Daisy. You can go about there. Chopping this whole piece into about four.
That?
Into about four pieces. Okay. So like there. Doesn't have to be precise, just rough. Yeah, that's fine. Next one. There you go. Two more on that.
I can't cut it, there's other celeries.
Away. Okay, well done. And then we're going to chuck these down the middle.
Well, first you want to
so
get
first
some
of all,
carrots and peel them.
Oh yeah, but I think that's fairly obvious, isn't it? Mm-hmm.
Stuck into the celery.
So dig it in at the tip and then rock it back, whack it.
That's
dig
good.
It in at the tip, rock it back gently, whack it.
One more. Oh, wait.
Yeah, we'll pick that up.
I thought celery fell down there.
Rock it in. Awesome. Hold it tight. There we go.
There.
Cool. Now, what are we going to do with that lot, Daisy?
We're going to throw it into this pan.
Okay, cool. Go for it. Does it matter where it goes, or can it just all go?
No, it can just go all over the place.
Okay, that's good, because that's where it's going. And then what do we put on it?
Half a cup of flour.
Oh, that comes later. What we need to do first is just toss that lot in a little bit of olive oil. Now we're just going to pour a little bit of olive oil over the top and then toss it all around. That's probably about right, Daisy. Now get your hands in there and flip it all about, get it all covered a little bit with olive oil.
A everything needs to get covered with at least a little bit of oil.
Yeah. And then...
It doesn't matter if your hands get greasy.
No.
You can always wash them.
Yeah. And then what we'll do is we'll put the chicken on top of that lot. And all the juices from the chicken will come out.
This is not to do with the gravy.
This is how we make the gravy. This is going to make the best gravy in the world.
Oh yeah, because you use the chicken fat.
Yeah, so all the chicken fat and all the juice comes out of the chicken into the vegetables. Some of the vegetables around the outside get little burnt bits on, little golden bits.
Yuck.
Yum.
Yuck, onions.
And then when we take the chicken out, then we put some flour in there and a bit of stock. Yeah, that will be perfect. And then we're going to roast that in the oven for about 15 minutes before we put the chicken on it. And that is about that for that. And we will be back in a minute. Daisy's going to wash it. Right, so now our beeper has gone off on our potatoes. So we're going to empty some of the water into this jug. Because it's salty water, we don't want too much of it. But it does have all that goodness from the potatoes. So we're going to do half that. Water in there. We'll fill the rest up with normal
water. Where the stock cubes are, and you need two of them.
Yeah, over here, Daisy. We're going to empty the rest of the water out over here, drain them off. And then this is one of the little secrets. You see, what we're going to do now is we're going to chuck the potatoes back into the pan. And then we're going to toss them between the two things. But so you get all of these lovely little fluffy bits around the outside of the potato. Those will turn to crispy golden awesomeness in the oven. That's how you
and
get the
that
best.
Part will turn into roasted the
other, yeah. And the other secret is to now leave these on the side, just to, all of that steam will come off and the potatoes will dry out. And don't, basically what you don't want to do is put wet potatoes into hot fat. You've got to have dry, fluffy potatoes into hot fat. So we'll leave those on the side. We're gonna chuck our vegetables in the oven for a little bit, and then we'll come back and show you how to prepare your chicken. Okay guys, so what are we doing nowadays?
Oh no! We're covering
William's here as well, by the way, now he is.
My brother. So we're covering the chicken with
his
oil.
Really!
Has blood.
No, we are not putting that on YouTube.
Okay, anyway, back to the cooking. We're covering the chicken with oil, and then we're
going to... No, Daddy, you cannot post that.
Chill out. Then we're going to put some salt on there, and I usually put some garlic granules and some herbs and stuff on there, but the fussy one doesn't like it, so... Oh, Will, chill out, dude.
Come on. My God, why did you?
That and you know, if you do not have a toddler dipping his spoon in stuff, it does help. So we'll be right back once we've covered this little fella in oil and salt. Right, so what we've got here is our vegetables that we put stuff on earlier.
Can I come show you the vegetables?
Yeah, keep your hands away from it though.
I will.
Those
are the celery, onions and carrots.
Now we're going to grab our chicken.
That we just greased and we'll send something very hilarious.
Okay, and then we've got the oil that came off. Chuck that on there. Now that is going to go... Find the back of the pretty stuff, not the gross stuff. Right, stand back on your... Terrible camera work, Daisy. You're going to have to work on the camera work. Okay, so the chicken's going to go in. Just there.
And I think the oil might come out.
Oil. Will, sit down please, mate.
And the very hot oil will
very
come out.
Very hot oil over here.
Can I get down?
That's the potatoes.
Can I get down?
Yes, you can.
Go in, but I think they might...
pour our oil in. We take the small boy off of this side.
Bye-bye.
Right, over here, please.
Okay.
Eyes on the prize.
And then this oil. I can't get a good view, though.
We've got really hot oil, and then we're just going to... Ow!
yourself.
Yeah, I've just burnt myself.
but please don't do that.
Toss the potatoes in the oil. Get a bit of a covering on each one, because that is how they get all golden brown. Now,
top shelf
of the oven.
Top shelf, make sure it's
200 degrees, chicken in for
an
hour. Potatoes will take about an hour as well. Set the timer for 30 minutes.
And make sure you might want to keep an eye on them.
And you will, we're going to take them out after 30 minutes and turn them and put
and
them back in.
And maybe keep an eye on them.
So
don't go chopping
a
tree
down. What is the camera looking at? A picture of the oven is not really interesting, is it? Faces when we don't have any looking to food. Okay. Food when we're doing the food, faces when we're not doing the food.
Okay, I'm terrible at this.
Cool. See you in a minute. Right, so whilst I'm on my own and there's no one to help me, I thought I might just explain how we do the Yorkshire puddings. It's quite important. And so we don't want to be messing around. What we need to do is, I'm going to turn the camera around and I'll be right back. Okay. So what we've got here is a standard muffin tin, and what we want to do is just put a little bit of oil in the bottom of each of these, and then what we're going to do, try and get a roughly similar amount of oil in each one, and then what we'll do is we're going to just chuck this whilst it's cooking, so it gets super hot. You want it mega smoky. Okay, so what we've got here is a standard sort of muffin tin, and I've just drizzled with one of these. This gives you quite good control over the oil that's coming out. Just drizzled a little bit of oil into the bottom of each of these. If you have a similar amount of oil in the bottom of each one, that helps. And then we're going to chuck this in the bottom of the oven now, whilst everything else is cooking. It doesn't matter how long it's in there for, it's just in there to get hot. So you can leave that in for the whole time. We're gonna keep that in the oven just to get incredibly hot. And then when we take it out, we're gonna pop it on the side here, put the heat on the gas, get it really smoking. And then you pour in your Yorkshire mix into each pot about halfway full, quickly back into the oven. And then you leave it there for 20 minutes. Don't open the door because they'll all fall flat. 20 to 25 minutes in the oven, full blast, 200 degrees. And you are gonna get amazing Yorkshire puddings. Watch this space. Right, so we've just taken the spuds out of the oven. They're about halfway through. As you can see, they're starting to get nice and golden and starting to crisp up. So we're just going to give them a little toss, turn them all over, so we don't want any potatoes that are kind of not golden on all the sides, so we'll just give them all a little turnover and then pop them back in the oven for the last little bit. They actually took a little bit longer than 30 minutes to start turning, sometimes they do. So there we go, those go back in the oven until the chicken's finished, and then we'll start making our gravy. Woo! Right, okay, so what we've got here is our Yorkshire mix and our stuff coming out of the oven. It's super hot, and now we're just gonna pour in our batter. Try not to get too much on the sides of it. If you get too much on the side between the two pots, it will actually pull the Yorkshire down. It will stop it from rising as big as you want it. You'll note I've got the hob on just a little bit underneath. The ones that are sizzling will probably get bigger. Right, and then quickly back into the oven. Quick. Top shelf. Make sure there's enough room above them that they don't hit the top when they rise.
and then they'll be done in 20 minutes. Right, chicken, that's out the oven. We're gonna put that on here, let it rest. Whilst that's resting, we're gonna cook the vegetables and prepare the gravy. In a minute, we'll show you how to do the gravy.
Covered in tin foil and a little blanket over it, keep it nice and warm.
And now, we're gonna have a look at this gravy. So what we've got here is all the cooking juices from the chicken, and we've got our vegetables. Now what we want to do is pull the vegetables out of the way, because the flour will just stick to them and get in a right mess. So we're going to pull those out of the way. And my hob conveniently has a slight left to right tilt on it, so that will actually help us keep the juices down one end. Now what we're going to do, crank up the heat a bit and just let some of that liquid boil away. So what we've got in there is a mixture of chicken juice, you know, the watery juice, but as well we've got chicken fat in there, and it's the fat that we really want. So what I usually do is boil it for a bit longer to get rid of most of the water and condense it down, and then end up with mostly fat, but I haven't got time for that. So today we're just going straight in with a quarter cup of flour, a little whisky fella, and we'll whisk that in. You'll see it absorbs all of the water straight away, goes to a bit of a paste, and then what we want to do is kind of cook that flour. If we don't cook the flour, you end up with a gravy that doesn't taste very good at all. So I'm now going to just brown that flour off a bit in this sauce, so turn it down a little bit and keep it moving. You don't want it to stick to the bottom of the pan too much, because it does go like glue. We'll be back in a minute. Right, we've got that cooked down a bit now. Flour is getting cooked. You see, basically what the flour's done is it sucked up all the water, and now it's just left the fat behind. But it's going to be fine. Don't need to worry too much. Now we're going to take the stock that we made out of our potato water and normal water. It's cooled down a bit, but it'll be fine. We're going to chuck up just a little bit of that in there. We can crank up the heat on it now, and we're just going to give it a stir. What that's going to do is, as the stock warms up again, it's going to break down the fat in the flour that's binding the flour together. All those little flour particles are going to separate out again and go for a swim in the chicken stock. As you can see, it's starting to loosen up already, and it's starting to thicken as well. That's when we hit it with a little bit more of our stock, and then we give it another stir. It's good to keep your veg out of the way while you're doing this. One, because they're starting to get a lovely bit of cooking going on over there. They're getting even more golden and lovely. And two, it keeps them out of the way while you're stirring your mixture up. So what we do is we just keep repeating that, let it gobble up the juice, thicken a little bit, and then add more water, more stock, and then stir, more stock, stir, until you've gobbled, well, basically a litre of stock up. Or, you know, you can stop if you think you're gravy's getting too loose. I'll be back once that's all gone. There we go, all stirred in. What I'll do now is just leave it to blip away like that, and it will give it a stir every now and again, and it will gradually get a bit thicker. And when it thickens up, if it gets too thick, keep a bit of stock back, and you can just add a little bit more stock in if it gets too thick. And there we go, there's some beautiful gravy to go with our lovely roast chicken. Our Yorkshires are in the oven. Don't know if you can see them, they're getting big. Wow.
Wow, look at those. How long's on the timer? 9 minutes left. Awesome. We'll finish our veg off and then plate up. Yummy, yummy. So, our Yorkshires are ready to have a look at now. Fingers crossed. Let's see what's going on. 1, 2, 3. Whoa, look at those bad boys. Like popcorn, aren't they?
Secret recipe. That's, to make those Yorkshires.
That's how you do Yorkshire's grave style. And our delicious roast potatoes. Look at those little fellas.
That I just tried.
Yeah, you'll notice that there's not as many in the pan as there was. That is because I took some of the smaller ones out. Before we put the Yorkshires in. Anyway, back up here, young lady.
If your Yorkshires aren't like this, you've done it wrong.
Exactly. Right, we'll see you when we put it all on a plate. Bye-bye. And there is our gravy all over our roast chicken, roast potatoes, massive Yorkshire pudding, broccoli and carrots for a little bit of something healthy. And what do we say, Daisy? Yummy.
Yummy! Delicious! I'm eating it!